Stranger in a Strange Land by Robert Heinlein. I just had a bunch of mic trouble and had to record this a couple times, so now I've got it right. We're gonna go ahead and do a good review, but it might be a little shorter because my voice is tired. I didn't understand before picking up Stranger in a Strange Land why Robert Heinlein was considered to be one of the greatest sci-fi authors of all time, and I can confidently say that now I do. He really elevated this whole genre with this story, and how he did that was he stuck with the traditional sci-fi idea of introducing one element to humanity and seeing how that would change us as a culture, as a people, as humans. And he made that thing character, what often is classic sci-fi's greatest weakness. And what results is a classic sci-fi story without what is arguably the greatest flaw of classic sci-fi. And actually, he created one of the most interesting characters I've read in a long time. Valentine Matthew Smith is fascinating. He is wonderful to follow, and while he does become fully fleshed out and you feel like you really get to know him, his actions remain unpredictable and you can never feel like you know his motivations, which lends an era of mystery and unpredictability to the story, which that drives the plot and the pacing to an extreme. I was unable to really put down this book after I got into it, and even disregarding Matthew alone, every character in this book is fantastic. Everyone from the main protagonist to the smallest side, just kind of plot mover, it's incredibly well done, and I praise this book endlessly for it. There was one nitpick I had that I could completely disregard because I understand this book was written in a different time, but the sexist rhetoric in this book is cranked to a 10, to the point where a woman looks at a man and says 9 times out of 10, if a woman is raped, it's her fault. Yeah, it was written in the 50s, so things like that were, I think, pretty standard to be in books like this. It just, to me as a modern reader, was kind of shocking. I don't know for sure if it was just kind of an accepted rhetoric back then, but it did stand out like a sore thumb to me. I kind of cringed and puckered at the line. It could be seen as an extreme juxtaposition of the overall message of the book, which is a message I really agree with to its core, and that is that openness and tolerance and peace are core aspects of goodness and something we should all embody as individuals, something that regardless of your creed, religion, race, status in life, is something I think we can all get behind. Overall, I can't really say much more about this book that hasn't been said again and again. The Library of Congress put it in the top 88 most influential and important American books ever written, and I think that really says it all. It is a must read, and while it might be difficult to push past certain aspects of the story and the rhetoric, it is worth doing, and I will go ahead and give it a awkward orgy with an alien out of 10, and yeah, put a seal of must read on it, because the way it clearly influences not only just the genre of sci-fi, but all of fiction for the decades to come is inescapable. So many authors have tried to recreate Valentine Matthew Smith, and I don't think many have come close to reaching that level of great character. That's just my thoughts and opinions. Please let me know what you think of the book down below, whether or not you're gonna read it, whether have you not. Can you really kind of easily put aside outdated, more racist, sexist rhetoric, or does it bother you reading a classic? Let me know. I'm interested to see how people kind of move past that, how they view it. Go ahead and like and subscribe, guys. Hit the Patreon to support my channel, what I do here. Peace.